he must have support in the House of Commons. Where's he going to get it from?
What about his renegotiation policy of the common market? Now, I know you always say to hell with the common market, but the Liberals wouldn't support him if he says to hell with the common market.
No, I don't say to hell with the common market.
You've said that. I've heard you say that at Labour Party conferences.
All I've said is this, that I thought from the beginning, I've never changed my mind, I'm unrepentant, that I think the economic community is bound to disrupt. But never mind about that. That's a prediction. What I do say is, to talk about renegotiation, well, it's very difficult to what we're going to renegotiate about, perhaps the common agricultural policy. That means trouble with the French.
Well, now, Lord Shinwell, we've got in The Hague, in Holland, one of the men who signed the Treaty of Rome when it was made many years ago, a former president of the Common Market Commission, and a man who is now critical of the common market in many ways, Dr. Sicco Mansholt. Good morning, Dr. Mansholt.
Good morning.
You remember we met in Oxford recently?
We did, yes.
And what do you think about the Labour Party's plans for renegotiating terms of entry, in particular major changes in the common agricultural policy, new methods of financing the community budget, retention by the British Parliament of powers over the British economy, and cheaper food from low-cost producers outside Europe for the British market, and so on.
Well, that's quite a programme that you're mentioning there.
Well, that's what they mentioned in their manifesto.
I understand, yes.
Yes.
Well, as far as changing the policy of the common market, it's quite clear that every country has the right to make proposals to do so, but he has to convince the others.
Yes.
So, in my opinion, the common market policy should be dynamic. It should not be static. When it is wrong, you should alter it, you should improve it. And there's a lot to improve. Several times I've said that in meetings in your country, that as far as social policy, you can develop a real social policy that's real, directed to the interests of the workers, and that should be done. Up to now, we failed to do so, and I very much hope that, for instance, when Labour comes in government, that they will be one of the great promoters of a good social policy in the common market. Secondly, we badly need democracy.
Now, Dr. Mansholt, are you saying this, that if a minority Labour government comes in and seeks to make changes in the common market on the lines that I have mentioned, quoting from their manifesto, are you saying that these are all things which can go on the table and be discussed? Are you saying they haven't got a hope of getting them through, or what?
No, well, that's not up to me to say what the hope is, of course. It all depends of the concrete and the specific proposal you're making. But every policy can be changed in the common market. And every country, United Kingdom or Ireland or Denmark or Holland, everyone has a right to make proposals and to discuss them. But what I say is you have to convince the others, because these decisions have to be taken in unanimity. It are major decisions, changing agriculture policy fundamentally, and there should something be changed in agriculture policy.
Hold
we
on.
All know that.
Hold on, Dr. Mansholt. I want to bring in again Mr. Helmut Sorge of Der Spiegel, who is in our London studio, and he's been listening with interest to you. Do you think that what Dr. Mansholt is saying means that there is quite a wide scope for negotiation towards some of the things which the Labour Party wants?
I think I wouldn't call it negotiations. I would call it readjustments. If you go and you find that something doesn't work, then you have to readjust it. But to say if you are not negotiating with us, then we move out.
But you, as a London correspondent, you know as well as I do that some of the Labour ministers are more interested in getting out than in renegotiation.
Yes, but I think they have a serious problem now. If you look at the voting, as it has been, the Liberals, who are pro-European, and the Conservatives, who have been pro-European, have actually the majority of votes, as it looks at the moment. So it means that possibly the majority of the English people don't want to get out. Now, if the party follows their line of bringing a referendum to the people, and the people are voting for Europe, the left wing of the party will have great problems.
Dr. Mansholt, what is your comment on that, and in particular that it's more a question of readjustment than renegotiation?
That's quite right. When I am saying you can always change the policy, it does not mean that you have to change the treaty, but because a treaty gives great lines. on the it's the base for a policy, but you can decide every agriculture policy on that base.
Could you just answer me one question before I ask a leading Labour newly elected MP to comment? Do you think that the terms of entry of Britain contained in the Treaty of Accession of last year can be renegotiated, as opposed to the readjustment process, the dynamic process, which goes on all the time?
No, it has not to be renegotiated, a treaty, the treaty of adherence. You can adjust it. You can adjust it. You can make another policy. Even you can change, let's say, agriculture policy fundamentally. When you don't want to have high prices, you want to have low prices, you can work with subsidies.
Yes.
You can apply a total other system of income policy in agriculture, and that is the main difficulty.
Hold on, Dr. Mansholt. I want to bring in Brian Walden, who is a Labour front bench spokesman in the last Parliament, and who was a frequent visitor to Strasbourg in the days when he was slightly more enthusiastic about the common market than he is now. Brian, what do you say to what Dr. Sicco Mansholt has been saying?
Well, our problem is a simple one, really. The Labour Party's not only pledged to renegotiate, it's pledged...
Renegotiate what?
The terms on which the Conservative government took us in.
The Treaty of Accession?
Well, yes, of course. And if you're going to call it adjustment, well, I'm not going to quarrel about words. But the real problem is this. Whatever happens in that renegotiation, we're then committed to hold either a referendum or a general election on that issue.
Well, you may have a general election sooner than you think.
Well, yeah, but that's the problem, you see. The general election, I suspect, if it happened in 6 months' time, wouldn't be about the common market at all. It would be about quite different things.
But do you really think that the various proposals listed in the manifesto for renegotiating the common market are, in fact, renegotiations, or are they proposals which will ensure that we will have to withdraw?
I think the possibility of withdrawal will be there. There's no question about it.
Breaking the treaty?
Breaking the treaty is a very hard word.
Well, what is the other word you would use?
Letting the British people decide this issue. I think when they do, they'll vote to come out. I think one has to face that. The British do not wish to belong to the European common market.
Thank you, Brian Walden. One brief comment on that, Dr. Mansholt.
Yes, in my opinion, that would be the wrong way to handle the whole thing. In my opinion, that is not any question of going out of the common market. It would even not be in the real interest of the United Kingdom. But what I can fully understand is that the Labour Party doesn't agree with, let's say, agriculture policy, and so they can urge for changing that policy. That's fully the right to do so.
Thank you, Dr. Mansholt, for joining us. Perhaps we may have another comment from you. Thank you, Brian Walden. And now, Alistair.
And our computer is back in business. During that conversation, you would notice the first result of the day.